A Senate inquiry into gun-related violence heard from some of the country's key crime experts, and apparently Australia is awash with stolen firearms.
This is the tip of the iceberg when it comes to illegal guns in Australia. Hundreds of firearms confiscated and destroyed in the escalating battle against black market weapons. The illegal gun trade is spiralling out of control, with at least 10,000 handguns and 250,000 rifles floating, unchecked, around Australia. Just three of the 237 handguns confiscated in New South Wales over recent years were imported. Most illegal firearms are stolen from licensed owners, then dumped on the black market.
It's absolutely vital we know where those handguns are coming from and how we can stop them getting into criminal hands.
Senator Penny Wright is heading up the inquiry, and while conventional guns are the clear and present danger, she also wants to focus on the potential of untraceable 3D printed guns.
We've heard that there's huge possibilities with 3D technology, and in fact it is possible to produce guns already, and so it's absolutely important that we're actually ahead of the game.
3D printing is in its commercial infancy, but as this motherboard doco shows, the ability to create a computer file for a semi-automatic and simply print it and fire is developing at breakneck speed. The 1996 Port Arthur massacre sparked the toughest overhaul of gun laws in Australian history. In the 18 years since, it seems some of that ground's been lost. So is it time for another round of gun reform?
Diana Blenkinsop became a victim of gun crime herself when her husband David was murdered 2 years ago, and she joins us now. Diana, thanks so much for speaking with us tonight. I was really surprised to hear those figures that came out today, hundreds of thousands of illegal guns in Australia. Are you?
Look, it doesn't surprise me, but it does worry me. Here in Perth, within the last 5 years, the crime rate, and particularly the homicide rate, has exponentially increased, and so has the use of illegal guns. So I can only assume that Perth is not an isolated case study and that it reflects nationally as well. So I'm not surprised, but yes, I'm concerned.